Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Indra Nabhan from IPMI International Business School MBA program batch 2020. I want to share about the summary of mind mapping that I got learned from corporate finance class delivered by Prof. Roy Sambel in the first until seventh week. Corporate finance is basically learn about financial management of a company, refers to activities and transactions related to raising capital for the creation, development, and acquisition of a business. Financial management described as optimal orchestration of internal and external financial towards significant and sustainability value creation. It is directly related to company decision which have financial or monetary impact. The most important thing is that we can understand and know how to implement the concept of corporate finance such as financial management, time value of money, capital budgeting, analysis of securities, portfolio investment theory, corporate restructuring, fraud risk management, internal national finance, dividend policy, and last but not least, we also watch the movie Wall Street Money Never Sleep, and we got many learn in this movie. Now, let's move on. The first part is financial management. We start with what are things that need to be a good manage in the future. We must know to finding and handling the capital structure, risk management, cash flow management, asset structure, working capital management. In this part, we can got the very good of goals of financial management with objective and value creation principle. For example, of value creation principle, the first is core of value growth, ROIC, health cash flow. Second is conservation of value using generate growth, ROIC, more than WACC, higher cash flow. The third is best owner. It means that a business value depend on who owns and manage it. This is related to the company ability and uniqueness to be the best in creating value. The last is expectation treadmill. It means to get a managed expectation of shareholder and fundamental performance. So, when the investor have more expectation, the company can improve and need to perform better and more better. That's why it's important to manage the company. The second part is time value of money. That is related with numbers. The concept means that the value of money is changed by time because of the interest rate. We can calculate the present value and a future value with this formula. This formula also used in the third part about the capital budgeting. Capital budgeting is a planning process for investment in a long-term asset and to get decision for making criteria for a long-term investment to answer better accept or reject for the decision. In order to do capital budgeting, we need use some methods to more preferred like NPV, IRR, payback period, and profitability index. The first method is NPV. It means the total of the present value of all cash flows subscribed by the initial investment, which is the project is acceptable if NPV is higher. The second is IRR. It's the same like to the calculate present value, but the interest rate is replaced by IRR. IRR is the discount rate that makes NPV equal to zero. We can accept the project if the IRR is higher or equal to required rate of return or interest rate. The third is payback period. This method is very simple because we just need estimate how many years does it take to cases initial investment, and the last is profitable index. Okay, next in the fourth part, of course, we learned also analysis of securities. First of all, we must to know about the two type of investing before we can analysis of securities to get the power of investment strategy. There are passive investing and active investing. passive investing is when we just follow the market. Meanwhile, active investing, the investor tried and actively evaluated the securities company that we invest to get the reason to invest in buy or hold, something like that. Now, talking about the analysis securities, this part can get the evaluation first based on the technical analysis using like repeated pattern, beta, CAPM, and WACC analysis. The second is fundamental analysis is related to the internal of the company itself. We can also using financial ratio and financial statement to understand the condition company. And as the active investor, we can know better about the market, liquidity, efficiency, leverage, profitability ratio, P&L statement, balance sheet, cash flow statement analysis. The company is healthy or not healthy using DuPont analysis, and last but not least is a Warren Buffett approach to investing, which is business tenet where he analyzes the performance of the company, management tenet like the management rationale and the candid with the shareholder, financial tenet where is he focus on ROE not EPS, and the market tenet where he analyzed the position or tenet the business in the market. Therefore, in the fifth part, there are a portfolio theory to analyze more about the combination like correlation, beta, variance using CAPM, return and risk using systematic and systematic risk, and also using expected actual and required return of the securities. Now, in the sixth part, let's talking about the corporate restructuring. That is related with process integral finance distress, surviving and transforming business, outcome of financial distress, restructuring corporate structure, and a value creation in this class session with Prof. Roy. We learn about a very interesting case in the leverage buyout or LBO of RGR Nabisco case. Next, in the seventh part, in the fraud risk management, there are four types. The first is occupational fraud and abuse, such as a corruption, asset misappropriation, and fraudulent statement as a threat. The second is fraud triangle, and we learn the reason why the people do fraud mainly because of perceived opportunity, perceived pressure, and the rationalization. The third is a whistleblowing system, and we can use to solve this problem with the four types of incentives such as physical, monetary, social, and moral. Next things in the eighth part that we are learn in our corporate finance course in about the international finance. There are four important topics here. First, foreign exchange, future contract, option market, like put and call, and arbitrage. So in the foreign exchange, we learn that currencies are allowed to be as intermediaries. In the future contract, we learn that there are exchange currency future contract that are specifically at the standard volume of a particular currency to be exchanged on a specific settlement date. And in option market, we learn that a currency call, like a put option, could give us the right to buy sell a specific currency at a specific price called the strike or exercise price within a specific period of time. Last is about arbitrage. There are three types of it. First is locational arbitrage that enable us to capitalize on the discrepancies in the arbitrage exchange rate across location. Triangular arbitrage that enable us to capitalize discrepancies in the cross exchange rates, and covered interest arbitrage that enable us to capitalize on the discrepancies between the forward rate and the interest rate differential. It means we can make the money by only buy and sell the foreign currency. Alright, let's moving on the next part about the dividend policy. Why company pay the dividend? Yes, because the company should pay dividend because the first in the point of view of investor that dividend is not taxable, and the second is signal the company cash is really there, which is the company capable in creating cash and to the reduce against the cost come from free cash flow. And last but not least, we also watch the movie Wall Street, Money Never Sleeps, and we got the money learned in this movie, as I mentioned before in first part. For example, for issue in the financial in this movie, in stock trading or fundamental activities, if we look in the short term and long term analysis, there are no prospect and the stock we have already losing a lot. It's better we action to cut loss and the loss all of the money. We can also see the sentiment such as the news coming from investment companies to anticipate for the bad risk. There are many risks that are exposed when we make investment. And before investing in a company, we must to the make sure to the analyze the financial statement of whether the company is healthy or not healthy, and we can compare it with the similar sector to make a future prediction to the investment. And in this movie, we also learn about the greed is good, because we also like the motivation to be a better person, have a very a great spirit with good strategy to get achievement, and we can dream for the richer with the well-prepared management in the future. That's more or less the summary that I got learned at the first until 7-week class delivered by Prof. Roy Semble. I have a quote from Walt Disney, "If you can dream it, you can be it." I think it's the same with the investment, because if we can dream to hire and increase our portfolio in stock, we can do it. Hopefully you guys get the benefit of the summary on this video, and thank you, see you at the next video sharing. Keep healthy, keep stay productive, and always happy. Goodbye.